10 ebooks. I have a couple of podcasts. I have 122 applications that are vying for my attention. And 2,500 songs and 1,200 pictures of my 2.5-year-old niece. So that's a lot of things vying for my attention. My brain, though, and this device are really only capable of doing one thing at a time. So mobile makes it worse, not better. It's gonna, yes, it brings everything to our pocket, but soon it will literally bring everything to your pocket. You're gonna fit absolutely all the content we want in your pocket. So again, we're all gonna start to, we're gonna have problems. Because as individuals, we're not gonna know what to look at first. The whole concept of multitasking is really not, it's kind of a joke. Because you can't do two things at once. You really only can do one thing in your brain at a given time. So I think what's happening is that the world is taking a deep breath and they're saying, enough. I can't do it all. I can't do it all. I'm going to make choices about what I'm going to let into my head and when. Some of these choices are going to be conscious decisions that we make. I decided about 3 years ago, I am no longer watching the local news in New York. Because honestly, every night I would turn it on and somebody was murdered. Okay? And you know what? Thank God it's nobody I know. And it's nobody it's in some part of the Bronx or something like that where I don't know. Or Brooklyn. And I didn't need to know that. That was a waste of my time. So I made a conscious decision. I'm not going to pay attention to local news because it's the murder. In New York City, it's the murder of the night. But I think we're all doing that in some way or another. Sometimes you have kids, your life is busy, that's it. That choice is going to be made for you. But I also think that subconsciously, we're starting to make the same decisions. We're starting to say, quietly, we're starting to do things that are narrowing our attention. So I don't have numbers for Indonesia. I only have numbers for the U.S. These are from Nielsen. But the average American visits 111 domains a month. Which, if you think about it, isn't a lot of domains. Now, that's a curve. That's what we call a bell curve. There are some people who visit 2 web pages a month, like my mom. My mom goes to Gmail, and she goes to RogerEbert.com. Okay, that's it. Roger Ebert is God in my parents' house. Don't think it's, you know. But some of you probably go to 1,000 domains a month. You probably don't even know how many domains you get. This includes everything. If somebody sends you a link to the BBC.com and you never visit that website, that counts as one domain. If you go to Twitter.com 10 times a day, that counts as one domain. So what this translates to is 2,500 web pages a month. So now 2,500 web pages, and that's US. I imagine in Indonesia it's lower. This doesn't count mobile. They haven't been able to count that yet. So it actually, when you look at mobile, it might be a little bit different. This is like, this is like every car in Indonesia trying to get on the main road here at the same time. And your car, I'm a car, Burger King is a car, Starbucks is a car, Carrefour is a car, Telecom Indonesia is a car. And some of these cars are bigger, some of them are smaller, but everybody's trying to get into this space. And you know what? You're all not going to fit. And increasingly it's going to be a highway that just goes by all the time. So it's going to be a real challenge for anybody who wants to be seen and heard, to be seen and heard. But there are some things that I'm going to tell you today that I think will help you that I'm telling my clients. First of all, just also noting here is that this is all about snacking. Now, people don't eat, on the internet, people don't eat meals. We snack all day long on content. That content can be tweets, or Facebook status updates, or even just news updates. Most people online do not read. I know it's a shocker. But most people online don't read. Most people read 20% of a web page before they click and they visit the next page. 20%. So that's nothing. They spend, maybe 6 seconds on a web page, and then decide they should move on. So it's snacking. It's snacking all day long, especially as more of it is consumed from mobile devices. And to make matters worse, we have found through our own study that people need to hear things 3 to 5 times before they take an action or they trust it. So on top of all of everything I just showed you, that pile of information, you don't just have to be there once. You got to be there 3 to 5 times before somebody says, oh, I need to follow Nanda on Twitter. He's got good stuff. I have to see 3 to 5 new tweets of his. I have to see news about a new product 3 to 5 times before I think, maybe I want to buy this. Or I have to see a story that's inconsequential to my life 3 to 5 times, before I will care about it. I had to see Lady Gaga 3 to 5 times before I realized I should pay attention to Lady Gaga. Now I have no choice. So 3 to 5 times before things sink in, on top of that, not easy. So let me give you some things to think about. Also, the one thing also I want to note here is that increasingly, social media is going to be a big part of that, those number of domains, those web pages, and the time spent will be on social media. You guys should be proud of this. In Indonesia was one of the fastest growing regions for Facebook in February 2010. Facebook grew in Indonesia from 17 million users on February 1st to 19 million users on March 1st, which is approximately 1.792 million users, or 10% growth. You added nearly half as many people to Facebook's total count than the U.S. The U.S. added 4.6 million. If you look at it, you have more users than Germany by a factor of 2. You have more users than Italy. You have more users than Mexico, than Turkey. Turkey's slightly ahead of you, sorry. All right, we'll catch up, Turkey. And France, okay? Well, French people are, they don't like a lot of things, so. Nobody goes to France, right? Don't tweet about the France thing, because I go there once a year or so. So, anyway, you should be really proud of that. That's wonderful. So, but you know what this means? This means that people are going to Facebook now more than they're going to your site. So you got to make sure that you're there. So I want to give you some things to think about. Okay, next. And it's increasingly about employees. People don't want to talk to a brand. They're not going on Facebook to converse with a business or an institution. They're there to talk to people. They want to talk to people like themselves. And I think that the companies that do the best are the ones that actually put their employees out there front and center. You will increase your surface area. This is all about surface area. If you put your employees out on Facebook and let them become ambassadors for the brand, for the business. It's about scale. So employee engagement, how you engage your employees, how you empower them to go out there, so that each of you builds a direct relationship with somebody from a company, not just the company, whether it be on Twitter or Facebook or YouTube, any of them, is going to be important. So I'm telling every company I go see, put your employees out there, please. Because they have expertise and thought leadership that they can share, that others will find valuable. So, okay, so you heard me set it up. Lots of things vying for your attention. Lots of choices, too many choices. I want to give you 3 things to think about. Now, these are written in the context of business, what they mean for companies. But if you are an individual, I think it works for you too. So I want to make sure I give this to you.